Presented by ChurchTechU.com, it's the ProPresenter Show. On today's show, how to do a picture-in-picture for your live stream in ProPresenter 7. Hi, and welcome again to the ProPresenter Show. This is the show where I help you learn all about ProPresenter. My name's Paul Allen Clifford. And before we get started, if you've ever wanted to be able to have a picture-in-picture of maybe the audience screen and then switch over to full screen of the audience screen with a picture-in-picture of the pastor or whoever, go ahead, give me a like, thumbs up, subscribe, all that fun stuff. So ProPresenter is powerful enough that it can do some features that are traditionally only done by a video switcher. And this is one of those. Earlier, I created a tutorial on kind of a hacky way to do it, but since one of the advantages of ProPresenter Plus is Renewed Vision has come out with a bunch of updates, and one enables you to do this in a much more intuitive way. And so that's what we're going to talk about today. So let's head over to my computer and take a look. So first off, I will confess I'm using a video switcher for this. So part of why I'm not using ProPresenter itself to do this while I'm doing this is because we get kind of some redundant stuff happening. So let me talk you through how to do basically what you see here, only, you know, it would be more like a full screen version. There's nothing actually selected here. Let's find, you know, maybe a full screen version of this, like this, with a little box in the lower right hand corner. Although it could be lower left, upper right, wherever you want to put it. It doesn't really matter, but it could be something like this. So, first thing we're going to need to do is we need to make sure that we have two distinct displays. The second of which will be what goes out that has the picture-in-picture on it. Just for the sake of this training, let's imagine that that's a live stream screen. And I'm going to go over here to Screens, Configure Screens, and I'm going to be using this NDI or Siphon output. I changed this based on what I need in the particular tutorial, but we'll do that. So that's the one that is going to have the picture-in-picture and the full screen behind it, okay? And then this regular one, that is not going to have the picture-in-picture. That's just always going to be the video of what goes out to the audience screen, okay? So keep that in mind. Regular is the regular full screen, and the NDI or Siphon output is the picture-in-picture. Okay. So the first thing that we've got this. Actually, let me go ahead and I'm going to apply a different look or a different theme to it. So I should have clicked on themes here, and instead of that, I'm just going to do, let's do this one. Okay, so that's pretty straightforward, normal stuff there. I'm going to get rid of this transition here and just click on default so that this goes back to the way that it was, and get rid of that macro. We don't need that. Okay, so now we're good to go. This is how it looks full screen. So that is the regular out, the regular audience out. Now, if I wanted to take that and make that a picture-in-picture in the lower right-hand corner with a full screen of the video, first I need to capture in the video. So let's real quick go up here to ProPresenter Preferences. You might already have this set up, but in case you don't, go to Inputs, and you'll need to add an input. Let's see here. Let's, instead of doing that one, let's just use my regular built-in FaceTime camera. So, yep, there we go. So that's a view of my desk. I need to do some cleaning, but you'll forgive me on that. Okay. So for my second screen, what I need to do, and that's this guy. So I need to get rid of everything that I don't need with a new look. So I'm going to go to Screens, and then Edit Looks, and I don't need messages. Actually, I could leave messages because I'm not going to use it, but I do not want announcements. And I do want the slide layer. I do want any media that I would have there. So I'm going to click on that here in just a second. But I do not want the video input right there. So props, yes. Slide presentation, yes. And media, yes. So if I do click on this, we see that like that. Okay, that's good. Now let's add a prop. So props are right here. Let's click on that and hide myself here. Notice that I've already been playing with this, but I'm going to guide you through exactly how to do this. So I'm going to add a new prop by clicking this little plus button. It's kind of hard to see, but it's right there by my mouse. And let's call that Camera Pip. Similar to this big Camera Pip, okay? And right click and let's edit it. Now, in this screen, we need to add that in. So let's add in a video input and let's drag that down here. I could stretch this if I wanted to make it the size I want it to be, but just so that it's easy to repeat, what I'm going to do instead is I happen to know that that's that this screen is 1080p, so I'm going to do 640 by 360. Oops. There we go. So, and now I'm going to drag that to where it's, let's say, right there. Okay. Now I just need to select the video input. Remember, it was number 3 that we just did. And let's go back here to the show. And with that on, if I just click on that, look, there it is. So if that's all you wanted, you're done. If you want the background of the main screen, but you want a prop, then just add that prop for the picture-in-picture and you're done. And notice that that stays no matter what. It is theoretically possible to put it on the slide itself, but that would not be the best way to do it. It's better to do a prop in this particular situation, because otherwise the main screen would also try and show that that box if you did it wrong. So with that said, that's the best way to do it with a picture in picture. But what if you wanted to reverse these two? What if you wanted this to be in this box and you wanted this to be full screen? Well, we need a different look to do that. So let's go into Screens, Edit Looks, and I'm going to add a different look here. We'll call this look full screen video Pip, main. Okay. The first thing that I'm going to want to do here is I'm going to, well, since I'm using the announcements layer, I'm going to get rid of that on everything. But I do want on the regular screen not to show the props. I forgot to uncheck that earlier, so make sure that you don't show the picture and the props on the regular one for this to work. For the regular, I can keep this as it is. I might uncheck video input so that if I clear this out, it doesn't show the video input by mistake. But what I'm going to do for this is I'm going to uncheck the slide and uncheck media so that it shows my background here. So let's make that live, and what I'll need to do is clear out this prop and swap it with another. So make live. Okay, and I also need to make sure in video input down here I have selected my video, my full screen video. Okay, so that's there. Now I just need to fill this with something else. So first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to right click and I'm going to duplicate this prop, actually, because I've already got the size and position right. It's just filled with the wrong thing. So I'm going to change this to, let's call this slide pip. And let's right click and edit this bad boy. Okay, so here we are on that. I'm going to click here, and instead of filling it with the video input, I'm going to fill it with a screen preview. What screen preview? The regular screen. So if we go back here to show in the upper left hand corner, and now if I select this, notice I have a screen preview of this, and if you watch it carefully, you can tell that as I'm clicking through different slides, this changes while this video remains the same. So that's how to do that. Now, how do I change between the two? Let's say sometimes I want it like this, and sometimes I want it the way that it used to be. Well, what I would do is I'd create a macro. So click here on the macros and click the little plus button once again. And the first thing that we need to do is we need to give it a name. So let's call the first one, let's say, full screen lyrics. You can call it whatever you want. And pip of video. Okay, just give it a name that you can remember. Now right click and let's add an action to it. So the first thing I want to do is I want to change the look to the one that we were on earlier. I believe it was the default look. Second thing I want to do is I want to add in the pip. So let's add an action of the camera pip, and it should be the case that clicking on that would have done it had I selected the appropriate look here. Let's try look one. It's what happens when you don't name things appropriately. So let's go back here into edit looks and let me fix that. So okay, I see the problem here. I've still got the announcement layer enabled for that. So props is not labeled. This is look one. Let me just rename that real quick so that I remember which one. And that is full screen lyrics. And if I click make live, yes, that does what I want it to do. Okay. Now, in order to flip this, I need another macro. So I'm going to click on that. And the reason I'm doing macros instead of just adding actions to one of these slides is so that I can reuse these week in and week out. So now let me do full screen video and pip lyrics. Okay, and right click, add an action to this one. First we want to change the audience look to full screen video pip main, and we want to add an action. We probably ought to clear the props first and then add an action, and I should have done that up here as well. I'll show you what happens if I don't do that. Add action, props, and that is slide pip. Okay, so now if I click on it, notice it swaps. So this, because I didn't fix that action. So edit actions, audience look. I actually want it to be that audience look. So if I click it, there we go. So there, that changes, and then that changes. And now I can go back and forth anytime I want by just clicking on those two macros here in ProPresenter 7. If you like this content, I bet you'd like my ProPresenter 7 Quick Start course, so head on over to TDM.fyi/pro, the number 7 and the word quick. Go ahead, give me your name and email address, and I'll make a login for you, and you can take that course for free anytime you want. Until next time, this is Paul Allen Clifford from TrinityDigitalMedia.com and ChurchTechU.com, reminding you to go ahead and